to Vienna, Austria, and last year was my first year.
I went to Juarez, Mexico for 2 years. I've been to Cosmo for the past 2 years.
I went to Haiti, and last year was my first year.
I went to the City of Children for 2 years, and I went to Haiti last year. I've been to Greece, Russia, Croatia, and Africa.
I went to Haiti, and last year was my first year.
I also went to Haiti, and last year was my first year.
I've been to Juarez twice, and I went to Vienna last year.
I went to Austria last year, and last year was the third year.
I went to City of Angels and Cosmo 1 year, and City of Children and Ensenada 2 years.
I went to Honduras last year, and it was my first time.
I've been to Russia for 2 years, and I went to Ecuador for my first time.
I've been to Cosmo once.
But still, you alone can rescue, you alone can save.
I plan on going back to Haiti this year because of all the relationships I made with the children. I can't wait to see how they've grown up.
I'm going back to Cosmo this year to continue the relationships I started.
I'm going back to Haiti this year because it was such an awesome experience and I can't wait to continue the friendships I made.
I'm going back to Honduras this year because the people there are amazing and it was a pretty life-changing experience.
I'm going back to Vienna this year, and the reason why is because my heart's so connected to the people over there and I've grown so much spiritually over there.
I'm going back to Vienna because of the friendships I made with the teenagers.
Lift up our eyes, lift up our eyes, you're the giver of life. You
My most memorable moment of the trip was my first year. We went to the special education school down there, and I played with this kid, and all he would do is like whistle, and that meant he wanted me to throw him a ball, and I played with him the whole time, and he always had like a huge smile on his face. My most memorable moment from a trip was when I got into one of the lunches we had with the little boys, kind of late, and one of my friends came up and told me they asked for me and where I was. So that was just kind of cool because I got to know that they really wanted to be with me and that I was making a difference.
The most memorable part of the trip for me was on the last night, Norma jumped in my arms and she wouldn't let me go.
I think our most memorable part about the trip was at the end, once we finished the house, we all would gather around and sing songs. Our first year, the whole team and the family gathered around the house and we joined hands and prayed out loud.
We all like crammed in the little house that we had built for them, and we like one guy had his guitar and we just all sang together, and it was just really like a cool thing. You like really felt connected.
I don't know why I believe in something I can't see. I only know that deep inside of me, like the air that I breathe, there's a hole. Won't let go. There's a peace that soothes my soul, and in my life I've seen it time and time again. There's an invisible hand that's guiding us all, holding us, helping us, under us, to catch us when.
A memorable experience I had in Africa was getting to paint a mural on the wall of a school. And when the elders of the community saw it, they were so blessed and the children were so excited that their school had been made a better place, and it was really awesome just to get to serve in that way.
We went and did a medical clinic in a remote village near Cap-Haitien, and my mother came in and she was like definitely like skin and bones, and she had a little baby with her. And she was 3 months old, but only weighed less than 4 pounds. So she was obviously in desperate need of some loving and some nutritious meals and some medical help. And luckily we were able to get that for her, and we were able to take her back to the hotel with us and nurse her back to health and put her in the orphanage. And
I try to let go the best that I can and trust in that end.
But when we were leaving, one little girl that I like bonded with turned around and said, "I love you," in English. And I tried so hard not to cry, but it was really sad and it was really cute.
After that, they pulled up a pickup truck and turned on the radio and everybody started dancing. And it was crazy how much fun everyone was having, us and them together. It was a really cool experience.
And a bunch of us adventurers strayed from the group, and we decided to climb a mountain and go through obstacles, and we learned to trust and we bonded with each other.
On the last day, we were saying bye to the kids, and Marjorie, the girl that I got really close to, she got her Creole Bible out and she started reading Psalm 100. And so I got my English Bible out and we started, she would like read a verse.
When the sweetness seems all gone, when the world's not on your side, remember I believe in you, my love.